I woke up at 6 o'clock in the morning to the rain, and I was the only one not freaking out about it. I thought we were gonna get married in the rain, and I didn't care.
Wedded.com, right up until a little while ago, didn't necessarily say this was gonna happen, so.
Fingers crossed. I was in the car digging for sunscreen.
Yeah, so it's people are out by the pool, and it's just, it's been so fun.
Yeah.
And even just being at the spa all day with the girls, that in itself, I'm thinking, this is a great day, but I thought it hasn't even really started yet.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
There's a full day ahead of you.
Yeah, I'm ready.
Now, for those of you who are married, do you remember the first time you met your spouse? For Chris and Katie, their first meeting was not a physical one, but one through the connection of social media, eHarmony, an online matching service. Well, they emailed each other for 2 months before finally setting up a meeting at a bar at Faneuil Hall in Boston in May 2011. Katie ended up being a few minutes late. She told Chris she'd be about 10 to 15 minutes late by texting him, and Chris thought, oh my God, she's gonna stand me up.
No, he said, be ready, be ready. They do that because everything takes longer. Little did he know that the pinches are anal about time. Really, if you're 5 minutes late, you'd be grounded.
Yeah.
And the vase is not.
I know. Sorry, I didn't know.
But she arrived as she said. Both had gone out on several first dates and were tenuous about going out on another first date. But they met and went to dinner at the Anthem restaurant in Faneuil Hall. And they hit it off and ended up shutting down the restaurant that night. Well, things were off to a good start, so they set a second date at Jillian's and then to a friend's Memorial Day party. Katie and Chris continued developing their relationship, and after dating for a month and a half, decided to make their relationship exclusive. Their relationship strengthened and developed over the course of the next year, and they decided to combine their resources and found a place together. Now, Chris knew that Katie was the one that he had to share his life with, even though marriage was something that they rarely talked about. So he went shopping for a ring in the spring of last year and found the one for Katie last Father's Day weekend. Katie's brother, Brian, had announced his engagement to his fiancée, Jamie, when they all gathered at Katie's parents for a Father's Day celebration. Chris's plan was to propose to Katie on a hike in the White Mountains the following weekend, but he decided to postpone it to give them some space between Brian and Jamie's engagement. So they took a ride around, they drove around, and came across this place called the Mount Washington Hotel, where we are today. Katie took a look at it and told Chris, you know, this would be a beautiful place to get married. Well, Katie goes home and talks to her mom, Kitty, about how impressed she was with the hotel, and that's all Kitty needed. This would be the ideal place to get married. Kitty wastes no time in getting in touch with the hotel about wedding packages. Now, keep in mind, Chris still hasn't popped the question yet, and Katie's still clueless. Well, a month goes by, and now it's the 4th of July weekend. Katie and Chris get invited to two parties on the same day. She wants them to split up to cover both parties. However, Chris convinces Katie to hang out at her parents' house because it's hot and they have a pool, and he had a plan. So they start the day with some early exercise by taking a walk at World's End, which is a reservation in Hingham near her folks' place. Well, Katie's off at a foxtrot going down the path, and he manages to slow Katie down as she was walking at a good clip. And they found a bench to sit and enjoy the view, although Katie had other plans and she said, why are we going to sit down and enjoy the view? At that point, he pulls out the ring, gets down on one knee, and proposes to her. Katie looks at him. Her comment to him was, not once, but three times. Are you serious? Well, it finally sinks in. She starts smiling and shaking, gives him a hug, and puts on the ring. Chris had already clued in her parents, so they had assembled the family and many of those in the wedding party here today. The champagne flowed, and Mom announces that she had booked the Mount Washington Hotel for a wedding on May 10th. And here we are today. So this is a day truly to celebrate.
I gave the approval.
Thank you, Chris, for taking Katie off our hands. You can step into my office later and we will talk to you about our no return policy.
I remember when Chris first proposed, Katie came running into the house insisting that I paint her nails to make sure her ring looked even more perfect on her hand. And being the youngest of four, everyone always did the talking for me, so I figured why stop now.
So remember perfectly the first day I met Chris. It was a gorgeous day, and I was lounging by the pool at my parents' house. Katie had prepared me by giving me the honorable privilege of being the first to meet this new guy. Not sure if that was a good idea or a mistake. But I can tell you, from the minute I shook his hand, I felt instantly comfortable. I will never forget that day for a few reasons. One being that I had never seen such pale skin on someone in my life. And with that, Chris had some of the most unusual sunburns I had ever seen. Being that I was the first one to meet Chris, I remember my mom asking what I had thought of Chris, and the first thing I said was, I mean, he's super nice, but boy, is he pale. But secondly, all jokes aside, I distinctly remember telling myself, okay, Em, take this all in, every second of this, because you'll have to recount all of this in your maid of honor speech. She's got a keeper. And turns out I was right. The moment I met Chris, I knew I was looking at Katie's future.
This is my something borrowed. This is something, Dad, did you give this to Mom? This is something that my dad gave to my mom, and so she's letting me borrow it. And then this is my something new. These are gifts from my parents, so. And then something blue, I'll show you what I have. My mom made me a bedspread for my first big girl bed. So, and so my mom found this. I don't know if she found the pillow or what, and so she cut out a little strip. So I like that. No one really will know that that's there, but we will. So I didn't even know she still had this. So yeah. Very special.
This never would have happened so smoothly without Kitty's attention to every bleeping detail, every single night for the last year. It was just truly inspirational and just shows her love and devotion to her family. And it was just phenomenal.
Oh my God.
You're putting us all to shame right now.
This is what I fell for 30 some odd years.
Look at you.
Nice. Okay. No, Kate, it's all about us, really.
Oh my God! I got on my tippy toes. Oh,
just don't help you put on.
They match your sash perfectly.
It takes a village to win, Katie Pinch.
Hold on, I can't see.
Chris is going to lose it when he sees
her.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Have you put in my bag?
I can't see.
Oh my God, I can't even take it off.
And then I'll show you guys later, but I have my something blue sewn into this.
Oh yeah, are you blanket?
Yep.
Oh my God.
Waterworks.
You are so pretty.
So,
I can't even
hear
you.
Oh my God.
It's not that bad.
Oh my God. You know what, Kate? Absolutely. Okay, if you two look this good together, I can't even imagine how awesome you're going to look with Chris. Really.
It's smile.
Yeah.
Yay. You know, the moment we met her, we just knew they were meant to be together. It's just, it's just amazing. And then meeting the family, they're all wonderful people. It's just such a fun merger. So happy for Chris. It's gonna be a beautiful day.
All right, girls, go ahead.
Mommy, you're doing
it. Yeah.
Woo-hoo. I'm ready.
Well, when I met with Chris and Katie several weeks ago, I got a chance to talk with them and get to know them better. And as we spoke, I could see how comfortable each was with the other. Both are each other's best friends, which is a key ingredient to a successful marriage. And when I asked them what did they see in each other that would make them want to spend the rest of their lives together, Katie told me that there's no other one in the whole wide world that she feels more comfortable around, as Chris is not only her best friend, but he lets her be herself. And he compliments her well, and he can always make her laugh. Now, when I posed the same question to Chris, he told me that Katie is his best friend as well. They have a similar family background with close family ties and long marriages. And he told me that Katie is beautiful, funny, and caring. And both told me that they have a mutual respect for each other and both have fun when they're together.
Now, deep breath. On to my little girl. Katie, seeing you get married today, just incredible. I just know it's the right thing. I know as you embark on this next chapter of your life, you're gonna be so happy. It was just tremendous. I mean, walking you up that aisle, you were in better control than I was. You wear your heart on your sleeve. You cherish family and friends more than anything else. You give yourself every day to students and everyone else, and I admired you to death. But you are gonna be a wonderful mother. You're gonna be a wonderful wife. Good, you stopped me crying. You know I love you very much. And I'm totally overjoyed that you found somebody as special as Chris to share your life with. Chris, I can see the love and devotion that you have for Katie, and it's obvious you're already soulmates. Your gentle demeanor and just your whole attitude is just wonderful, and somehow you're able to balance the piano wire over here and take care of her. And I know you'll take care of Katie for the rest of your lives, and nothing can make us happier. And we're just thrilled.
I, Katie, take you, Chris, to be my lawfully wedded husband.
I, Katie, take you, Chris, to be my lawfully wedded husband.
I promise to be your true friend and loving partner.
I promise to be your true love and loving partner.
I will laugh with you in times of joy.
I will laugh with you in times of joy.
And I'll comfort you in times of sorrow.
I will comfort you in times of sorrow.
I will share in your hopes and dreams.
I will share in your hopes and dreams.
And support you in achieving your goals.
And support you in achieving your goals.
I will listen to you with compassion and understanding.
I will listen to you with compassion and understanding.
And speak to you with respect and encouragement.
And speak to you with support and encouragement.
And I will remain faithful to you, my very best friend.
I will remain faithful to you, my very best friend.
And will love you and cherish you all the days of my life.
And will love you and cherish you for all the days of my life.
And I will love you and cherish you all the days of my life.
It's really funny that you guys chose All of Me as your wedding song. I actually wrote this long before you told me what your wedding song was. We went to a concert for John Legend, and we saw this song, and I remember we're all standing up, being all lovey-dovey after a couple beers with our significant others. I look over at Katie and Kerwin during All of Me, and the two of you were just staring at each other, doing nothing but singing, just like you were on the dance floor. And there was one real piece of that song that stuck out to me, and it is, "You are my beginning and my end." And that hit me pretty hard that day. What it really means is that you're the end. Individuals, as people, individual people, you're it's over. However, you are starting something far greater. You're becoming a unit, a team, an unfaltering solidarity toward a common life. And it starts today.
By the power vested in me by the governor and the state of New Hampshire, it is my honor and privilege to now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now share your first kiss as husband and wife. Please join me in giving a joyous round of applause to our newly married couple, Chris and Katie Kerwin.
Relationships were nothing but a waste of time. I never wanted to be anybody's other half. I was happy saying I knew love wouldn't last. That was the only way I knew till I met you. You make me wanna say I
distinctly recall Katie saying she wanted a simple yet perfect wedding. And quite frankly, now that the day has come and almost gone, I'm curious to know when simplicity is gonna kick in.
Say I do.
I love you like a brother. In fact, you are my brother, really. We've known each other forever. A true best friendship is one that makes your family question your sexuality. And we've had too many questions to answer, my friend. So everybody, to the bride and groom and the greatest couple in the world, Chris and Katie Kerwin. Cheers.
Katie and Chris, as you sit here today, you have so many wonderful adventures ahead of you, and it starts now. The only piece of advice we have, Katie and I have, is the best friends make best spouses. May you be best friends forever, and may you always strive to bring out the best in each other. We love you both. Cheers.
Y'all, thank you very much. It's a wonderful, wonderful party. Two wonderful people, two wonderful families, and some great friends. We appreciate you making us part of this evening. We got one more song for y'all. I think you might know this one. Sing along, have some fun.